Welcome back to the Margaret River Pro. This area was first explored by surfers from Perth way back in the early 60s. Cliff Hills, Rob Birch came down here. They started surfing up at Yallingup and then slowly made the trip down to Margaret River to these isolated locations. Main break, it was much later on that the box was tackled by some very brave locals. Jack Robinson, he is a massive mountain to overcome for Felipe Toledo, one of the major title contenders in 2019. Ronnie Blakey with Barton Lynch. This is a huge test for Felipe Barton. But Jack Robinson, we've seen him in a few CTs. He's never had a head-to-head win against a competitor, never won a man-on-man heat. Is this the day he's going to get it done?
Well, look at this. Look at the wave selection. Look at the positioning. Look at the composure. And look how he starts this heat against Felipe Toledo. Look at this angle, Ronnie, a beautiful angle. He's in easy, and he gets to stall. He pulls under that first little bit, knowing that it's going to cup out now and just go crazy through here. Double arm drag, slowing himself down perfectly, and there it is. I don't know that we've seen someone on such a perfect-looking wave yet this morning. They've all had some weird, moody bits to them that have made it challenging.
Toledo now looking for an answer. It was an excellent score for Jack Robinson to start off. Toledo locked in. Great barrel rider. Often underappreciated how well he surfs the tube, and he's going to find a pretty decent number himself. But Robinson's wave, it was deeper. It was bigger.
And it's interesting, this angle, to tell how deep you get. Beautifully stalled. Gets the right positioning. When he did those couple of little pumps there, I was thinking, well, don't get too far out. Stay back in there. But then that second bit, you watch here, that little pump there, those little pumps, I thought that he might have made himself exit too fast, but there was that chandeliering bit at the end, that section coming up that you'll see in a minute that he contemplates. So you see here, he's standing nice. Then he sees it and goes, actually, I'm going to give it some. And just parks it beautifully. The timing, the poise of a champion on display there. And what a couple of great opening rides.
Positioned himself very deep at the start of this one. The bottom drops out, but Jack's going to find his way through. Just negotiates all those steps with ease, where other competitors have looked a little shaky, getting a little front-footed. He just stands back, rides over all those steps, no problems, and expecting another solid score to drop.
The degree of comfort that he shows in the most critical situations. Here he goes, paddling super fast. You see the stroke rate there was amazing. And then just drops in, has that weight perfectly centered on the board, comes around here, this angle will be great. Straight in, parks it, the whole leap explodes over him. There was a chandeliering bit there that he punched his way through and into just a little lip tap there at the end, just to show how easy he's feeling and how at home he is right here at the box. He's local surf spot, so we expect to see this. But if you're Felipe Toledo, it's ominous.
Jack Robinson flies a drone from his bedroom to check the surf at the box before he gets up in the morning.
He told me that as well.
He is the man to beat. And he's going again. Late drop. Well positioned deep. Has the control to stick it. And will come flying through the barrel once again. So three waves, three big numbers. That might even be better than the seven.
I think it is better than the seven. The lateness, the criticalness of that drop. Felipe Toledo was right there with priority. Can't be so. Look at the stroke rate. Whack, 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 whack. Really fast. Up, drives in. Super deep, super composed though at the same time. Makes it look easy. And he's behind it too. Look, whoa, straight under. Better than the seven for sure, I reckon, Ronnie. And he's going to have his second excellent score. Felipe can come back. It's got to start pretty soon. He's got to show that determination. Going left.
Well, Jack, even with that manoeuvre, there's a level of comfort. Mm. You know, we've seen some people forced to go left. Jack Ben was just trying to make Felipe use his priority.
Another guy, and like, you see where you want to take off on the wave, but you kind of have to position yourself, like, accordingly to back them up. So it's a little funny. Like, I felt like there was a couple waves that I really would have loved to have been coming from behind and been in position for, because there's some more good waves to be had in our heat.
He's had those wins.
Yes.
He's really relied on his maneuvers, in particular his forehand and some of his aerial prowess to get those victories. Jack Robinson, on the other hand, he took out the Pipe Invitational. His big results have really come over on the North Shore. He's had a QS win at Sunset, and we mentioned earlier a win at Pipeline in a qualifying series event earlier this season. He's well positioned on the QS, but in the fifth place.
Exactly.
And the style of wave, the way that he's been in a rhythm out here. You would have to say he's just got the mana, as they say in Hawaii. He's got that thing of a local vibe, and you know, nobody's had that today. Nobody's come close to being on this many good waves over and over and over again. And he has put in the hard yards. He's, as you know, like, he's done so much time out here. He's got that energy. He's got a relationship with the wave. And, you know, he's done a lot of work just to get here.
Heftiest heat score total we've seen this year. And Felipe had this one during the break part.
Oh, that was nice. Look, he's way behind and the bottom just drops out. And he drops down then pulls that line through. That was one of the more critical waves we've seen Felipe have. Look at that drop there. Little arch and then pulls in beautifully. You need exposure to these type of waves because there's no way you can fudge
it. He did it very well, but you could have fit three of those barrels inside Jack Robinson's 9.3. Jack up again.
Fair to say.
3.5 minutes to go. Love to see Felipe just swing on a bomb in the final stages here. He's got that priority. He'll have that opportunity. Have a look at Jack swinging so late into this one.
Play time out there. Imagine being that comfortable. You can play in these sort of conditions.
Unbelievable. It's, you know, been what Jack has focused on. Just the barrel here, the barrels on the North Shore. But this year, really shifting his focus, starting to work on his turns more, has some great airs that he can go to.
Yep.
He's going to need those turns to keep this QS campaign alive. Currently sitting in fifth position on the QS. Now, if the event stays here at the box, he's got to be the favourite to win. Heat score total of the year, 18.57.
And a comfort level that everybody, we've seen Kelly Slater surf, Gabriel Medina, Italo Ferreira, we've seen the best.
Jake Patterson is in his corner as his coach, and they've been doing a lot of work out here, so that's going to be a big one for Kanoa. He's up against Ricardo Christy, who performed well here at the box last time we ran some championship tour competition at this location. 30 seconds remaining here. The result is in the bag for Jack Robinson. Reflecting on this heat button, there's so many highlights.
And just compose himself and walk away from this one and go, that's enough. Let me come back and do this all again. Because it's been, like I said, it's a masterclass. And the very best in the world will have watched this and learned a lot.
And his first man-on-man win, Jack Robinson. Not his first wild card. Felipe Toledo just enjoying a view, getting spat out of a barrel on his last ride, but he is going to be out of the contest.